Welcome, this is Dr. Plague, and today we're going to talk about simulating digital circuits on a computer. You see, in future videos, I'll be designing and building digital circuits, and part of the design process will involve simulation. I'm going to introduce you to a digital simulation package called DigitalWorks. As of the date I filmed this video, the full version of DigitalWorks is available for free, and I'll show you where you can get your own copy of it. In the past, you had to pay for the full version, but the developer has now generously made it available for free, so I urge you to get your free copy while you can. I believe there is only a Windows version of it, so if you're not using Windows, then this might not be the right software for you. There are other digital simulation software packages out there, but if you'd like to follow along with me in future videos, then I recommend you download a copy of DigitalWorks. What I like about DigitalWorks is that it's very easy to use, it has a very simple user interface, it's not overly complicated, and you can easily learn how to use it in a very short period of time. There is not a lot to DigitalWorks. It's very basic, but gives you pretty much everything you need to simulate even some of the most complex digital circuits. And to top it off, it comes with a nice library of simulated 74 series logic ICs. Plus, you can very easily design your own library components. So please, stick around and I'll take you on a tour of DigitalWorks. Using software to simulate digital circuits is a good idea to help save time when designing your next big project. But nothing is better than actually building your project in real life and seeing it work with your own eyes. So this is no substitute for the actual prototyping stage. And as a word of caution, just because a circuit appears to function correctly when it is simulated does not necessarily mean that the design will function correctly when you actually build it up. But it does help build confidence. There are some bugs in this software and with some of the library components, and we'll talk about those in future videos when we come across them. But don't let this turn you off. It is still an excellent software package, and you can usually find workarounds for any bugs that might show up. So first, let's get this software loaded up, and then I'll show you where you can download it. The software should come in a zip file, and when you unzip it and open up the main folder, you'll find an application named DigitalWorks. You can right-click on it and drag it to create a shortcut on your desktop if you'd like, or you can just double-click the application to start it. You'll notice that you're given this blank canvas to draw up your circuits. And all the options are in the menus and menu bars up here. First, let's go to the Help menu and look at the topics. You can learn everything you need to know about DigitalWorks in these sections, but let's click on Further Information. Here, the website is listed where you can go get your own free copy of this software. So, let's go to it. Let's choose Free Software on the left side of the screen. And DigitalWorks is the first thing shown. You can click here to download the software package. Perfect. Now, let's start showing you how this software works. I'm going to assume that you know at least a little about digital circuits, and if you don't, then you can use this software package to experiment and explore how digital circuits work. So, let's create a very simple circuit with a voltage source, a ground, and two LEDs. If we click on this plus sign up here, we can add a voltage source, VCC, and we'll pretend it is 5 volts. We can click anywhere on this canvas to add the voltage source, so I'll put it here. Now we can get a ground by clicking on this ground symbol, and I'll place it under the 5 volt source. If I click on this little circle, we can add a couple LEDs. There is a wiring tool right here that we can use to connect the wires between components. So let's wire VCC to one LED and ground to the other LED. Just left click to attach a wire. When we first add wires, they show up as black lines, but the cool thing is that the wires will change colors during a simulation to indicate what voltage is on them. Black wires will indicate 5 volts, or whatever positive voltage you're using. If the wires turn light gray, that will indicate 0 volts or ground. So, let's start the simulation and see this in action. All we need to do is click this play button, or as they call it, the run button. The simulation has started, and notice that the wire connected to VCC is black, and the wire connected to ground is light gray. When we apply a voltage to an LED, it turns on, so this one is red, and the one connected to ground is off. Click the stop button to end the simulation. Let's delete the grounded LED and change the voltage source to an interactive input. Just left click and drag to select what you want to delete and hit the delete key. You can also right click on something and select delete in the menu. Now, let's add an interactive input, which is this square with a circle in it. Let's wire it up and run the simulation. Now, if we select the object interaction hand, we can interact with this input symbol to turn the LED on and off. Just left click on it. Okay, let's change out the input for a clock signal. Which is this square wave symbol up here. We'll wire it up and run the simulation. Now the LED blinks to the clock frequency. By the way, you can go under the circuit menu here to change the clock speed. Now, let's delete the wire and add a switch. I'll wire the switch between the clock and the LED. Now, when we run the simulation, the signal can't pass through the switch unless we use the object interaction hand to turn on the switch. You can also right-click on the switch to change the type. Beautiful! By the way, we can pause and single-step the simulation if we choose, and we can select single-step in a half or full clock cycle. Now, let's create a new project by clicking on the blank page symbol here. Let's show how you can simulate logic gates. Up here, we can select from an OR gate, NOR gate, exclusive OR gate, exclusive NOR gate, NOT gate, otherwise known as an inverter, AND gate, NAND gate, and a tri-state device. So, let's select an AND gate and an OR gate and connect a couple interactive inputs, along with LEDs on the outputs. Now, if we simulate it, we can see that 5 volts on either input will send 5 volts out the OR gate, but we need 5 volts on both inputs to send 5 volts out the AND gate. We also have a selection of flip-flops here, an RS flip-flop, a JK flip-flop, and a D flip-flop. Let's add an RS flip-flop with an LED. Now, if we send 5 volts to the R or reset input, the LED will not light. But if we send 5 volts to the S or set input, then the LED will light up. By the way, you can change the color of the LED by right-clicking on it. Let's create another new project. And let's add a memory device. We can select either RAM or ROM, so I'll choose ROM with 4 address lines and 1 data line. I'll add interactive inputs to it and an LED. Now we can change the memory contents by double-clicking on the ROM and clicking on the bit we want to change. Press backspace, then enter the new value and press enter. I'll add a 1 to address 3. Click OK and start the simulation. The CS is the chip select line, and it's active low, so we want to keep it at 0 volts to turn on the output of the ROM. Now we can only get the LED to light if we select address 3. Which is 0011 from top to bottom in binary. We can click the A symbol to add some annotation if we'd like. Now, let's take a look at some of the library components. So, let's start a new project again. Click on the Parts Center and select the Master IC Set folder. Now we have Motorola and Philips parts to choose from. If we look at the Philips parts, then we can see descriptions for all kinds of 74 series ICs. Unfortunately, most of the list doesn't indicate 74 series numbers for the ICs. But you could choose View File Name to see the name of the files which have the full numbers. Let's drag the quad 2-input AND gate onto the canvas. And you can see we have a standard 74HC08 IC. We can right-click on it to view the datasheet. And you can see pins 1 and 2 are inputs to one of the AND gates, while pin 3 is the output. So, let's wire those up to test it. I'll add 2 interactive inputs and 1 LED. For the simulation, we do not need to add power and ground to the IC, but don't forget to add them in real life if you do this on a breadboard, for example. Now, if we start the simulation, you can see it behaves just like the first AND gate that we wired up. We need to set both inputs to 5 volts to light up the LED. Now, notice that if we double-click on the IC, we can see the insides of it. FYI, you should click on the arrow icon before double-clicking the IC, as the object interaction hand will not open it up. You can then click on the Close Macro button to back out of the IC. Now, let's go back to the Parts Center and drag in the BCD to 7 segment latch decoder driver. Notice that this is a 74HC4511. We can see the insides of it, and then back out again. Go back to the Parts Center, go up and into the test circuits. Now find the 74HC4511 test circuit and pull that in. Now go inside of it to see the test circuit, then simulate it. By the way, the 7-segment LED is located up here if you want to use them in your own circuits. Now, let's add a couple LEDs to the bottom 2 output pins. And right-click on the LEDs to add the text 1 and 2. Then, right-click on the LEDs to add them to the logic history. Do the same for the clock signal. Now, go under the Tools menu and open the Logic History window. You can see the clock 1 and 2 listed in the logic history. Run the simulation, and you can see the waveforms for the clock and signals 1 and 2. You can toggle the display mode by clicking on the computer symbol. This switches back and forth from binary to waveforms. Note that the stop button in the logic history window looks like a record button, so that was probably a mistake. Now, let's back out and start a new project again. Let's pull in a sequence generator, which is next to the clock, and let's pull in 3 interactive inputs. Let's add an LED. Then, let's pull in 2 tri-state devices. Connect it up as follows. Now, right-click on the sequence generator to add any desired sequence. I'll choose 5A in hexadecimal. Now, start the simulation. Notice that if we turn on the upper tri-state device by clicking this interactive input, then the sequence from the sequence generator is sent to the LED. And if we turn that off and turn on the other tri-state device, then the interactive input on the left controls the LED. But if we try turning on both tri-state devices, we get bus contention and the simulation stops. If you did this in real life, you could damage your ICs. Now, let's try creating our own IC. We'll use this circuit as our innards, but let's get rid of the sequence generator, interactive inputs, and LED. Let's replace those with tags, which is this little square with an X in it. The tags will allow us to connect wires to pins on an IC. We'll need 5 of them. Let's wire up the tags. Now, right-click on the upper left one and select Template Editor. Go to Open Template under File and select the Templates folder. Open the first one, the 8-pin DIL. Alternatively, you could also design your own templates with these tools here. Right-click on the first pin and select Associate with Tag and X out of the window. Notice that the tag now has the number 1 next to it to indicate that this is pin 1. Do the same to add the rest of the pins as follows. Now, right-click on the IC text and select Edit Annotation and give it a new name, such as My IC. Notice that the text color is white, so you can't really see it unless you highlight it. You could also change the text color if desired. Notice that the tag for pin 5 needs the text adjusted to the right, so right-click on it, select Tag Text Style, and choose Right. We could go under the Tools and Options to attach a data sheet, but we don't have a data sheet to attach. So, let's just save this as My IC in the Parts Center folder. Now start a new project and open up the Part Center to find our new IC and drag it in. Now you can double-click on it to see its innards. Close the macro and let's wire this up to see if it works. I'll add a sequence generator, 3 interactive inputs, and an LED, and wire it up. Don't forget to edit the sequence. Now let's simulate it. The right 2 inputs activate the tri-state devices. Now you can see the circuit operates just like before, and if we activate both tri-state devices at the same time, we get bus contention. So our new IC works. And that's how easy it is to create your own ICs. There are still a few things we haven't touched on yet. You could add in a numeric output device, and you can play around with that yourself. You can also use a logic probe here to probe the wires, but since the wires turn colors, it isn't of much use unless you pause the simulation and move in and out of macros, since the current state of wires isn't updated. But the logic probe should always give you the correct state. You can also explore the rest of the menus to see what else there is to play with. One thing that I've noticed that is missing, unless I just haven't found it yet, is that there appears to be no way to zoom into the circuit that you are designing. It would be nice to be able to zoom in, especially when you start getting to be my age and your eyesight isn't as good as it used to be. Other than that, I think the developer did a nice job with the software package. I think I've shown you most of the basics, and this should be enough for you to get started with your own designs and simulations. Wow, that was a lot of fun, and I hope you've enjoyed this quick little introduction to DigitalWorks. Now you can go play around with it and have some fun designing all kinds of digital circuits. If you liked this video, then please peck at that like button and consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. Thank you, and I'll see you next time, right here on Dr. Play.